very pleased to say that we're lucky to have the brand new Fujifilm X-T2 with us here today. So we'll do a little unboxing video for you, just so you can have a look, see what comes in the box, and we'll go through the camera, first impressions. So here we have the normal Fujifilm black box. Let's open it up. And I do love the Fujifilm packaging. This cutout X on the top looks really cool. We open up there, normal gump from the top that we won't bother looking at. And here we go, here's the camera. So as we can see, lovely bit of kit as always from Fuji. Lovely substantial metal finish. Feels great in the hand. The grip is lovely and deep. It feels definitely a bit more refined than the X-T1 in terms of holding it. It feels great. The dials are taller, much easier to grip onto, and they're actually locking dials. So we've got a push to unlock, push to lock, which is going to be a hugely welcome addition, I think, to a lot of people. Looks like the record button has gone. That's now on the dial over here, on the select dial. And we have the fabulous joystick from the X-Pro 2, which makes AF and all those kind of functions very much more accessible. These buttons have been improved as well. They're slightly larger, so they're much easier to press now. So otherwise, it looks very similar to the X-T1, which is obviously no bad thing at all, because it was a great camera. There's another little cheeky switch here I've just noticed. So we have the normal moving screen as we had on the X-T1, but if we pull this, we have a portrait mode. So now you can hold it up vertically and still get that articulating screen, which is great. The eye cup, they've gone with the larger eye cup now as well, as standard, which I know a lot of people upgraded to with the X-T1. So as you can see, alongside the joystick which we saw from the X-Pro 2, we also now have dual card slots, but unlike the X-Pro 2, these are both UHS-II compatible. So two high-speed SD card slots on the body, which obviously for professional users is a huge, huge deal. So just putting that to one side, let's see what else we have in here. So, charger, the strap, European power plug, and a small flash, which, yeah, should you need it, just gives that a little bit of extra light. Now, along with the X-T2 comes this, the new VPB X-T2, which is the new power grip for the X-T2. So you can see a lovely deep grip, but there's a few new buttons on here. We have a function button and a cue button. And then going around to the back, we have a joystick. And intriguingly, we have this button down here, which is normal and boost. Now I believe this gives some added performance to the camera when you put it in boost mode, like in increasing the viewfinder frame rate and increasing the continuous rate of when you're doing continuous shooting. And if we look in here, yep, we have a battery tray which features holes for two batteries. So you see, it makes it really substantial. There we go, the brand new X-T2 from Fujifilm. Okay. Hi Pete.
Graham, nice to see you.
Nice to see you, yeah. Thanks for coming to Castle Cameras today to share this exciting new camera from Fujifilm with us. The X-T1 was a huge success for Fujifilm, I'm sure you'll agree. It caused many photographers to leave conventional DSLRs behind and join the mirrorless bandwagon. So the X-T2 has got some pretty big boots to fill, as it were. What new features does the X-T2 bring over the X-T1?
Can I take the camera?
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Yeah, the X-T2 actually is an evolution of the X-T1 and has the driving, the powerhouse of the X-Pro2 behind it inside as well. You've got the 24 megapixel X-Trans 3 sensor and X-Trans Processor Pro, which we introduced in the X-Pro2. Of course, there's been some months of development of that combination since we launched this, and so it's been honed just a little bit more. The camera externally, if you want me to go through the external differences, has a number of ergonomic features which improve it. You've got a bigger grip.
So yeah, slightly deeper grip and wider over the X-T1. Yeah.
We've taken away the looking at the top plate. We've taken away the button for recording.
For the record button there. Yeah.
And that's been incorporated in this in the drive button around or the drive mode selector around here. So we now have the movie mode on here. The other thing that we've done is made these dials easier to change. You've got the shutter speed dial and the ISO dial are taller.
Yes, they are quite notably taller, actually, aren't they?
And also lockable. The locking mechanism on both of these is different. It's lock on, lock off by pressing the button, okay, rather than press and turn as
press
on the
X-T1. Press and turn on the X-T1. Yeah.
The ISO native ISO is 128,000. 12,800. That's the next model, probably. Joking aside, and you've got an 1/8th of a second now, so you increased
the mechanical shutter speed. Is one up by a stop as well. Yeah.
The ISO dial, we've used the same system as on the X-Pro2, so you now have the C mode, which enables you to give up to plus or minus 5 stops of exposure compensation. On the back, we have the little focus lever here for focusing area. That's been taken from the X-Pro2.
Fabulous joystick.
The joystick.
Yeah.
And that's about it. Bigger eye cup.
We've got some deeper buttons as well, haven't we?
Yes.
More pronounced.
Yeah, more pronounced. These are This was something that had been noticed on the earlier versions of the X-T1. So these stand prouder off the. Yeah.
We've got any differences on the LCD panel as well?
Yes, that's the one little thing I was leaving till last. So you've got the LCD panel is the same as that. Plus, with this lock here, you now have vertical.
Excellent.
As well as horizontal tilt.
So if you're shooting a portrait, you can pull the screen out.
Yeah, you can pull the screen out or raise it above your head,
sure,
depending which way around you turn the camera.
Excellent. Okay. So yeah, so coming into stock soonish?
Well, announced 7th of July, and stock will be shipping at the beginning of September.
Excellent. Okay, so we've seen the X-T2 and the great features it brings, but along with that, there's some great accessories like this new battery grip, which I think has been produced to go with the X-T2.
Yes, the new battery grip is fantastic. You've got more than just a battery grip. We now have two batteries in the grip.
Okay.
So that will give you, combined with the camera battery itself, you will get about 1,000 or more shots.
That's incredible.
The controls on there here, we've now been able to add the joystick.
Excellent.
For focusing, which is on here, so that's duplicated. We've got a Q menu and a function button as well, in addition to its predecessor. There's also a boost switch here, so that will give you an extended frame rate on the viewfinder, so and you'll also get 11 frames per second on the continuous high shooting.
So really, really fast shooting now. So
yeah,
I think really taking it to the DSLR market.
Yeah. One thing we should mention about the DSLR market is that this can start to compete now with DSLR shooters who are shooting continuous shooting, the amount of blackout in the viewfinder is has been reduced now to 114 milliseconds from 280 milliseconds on the X-T1.
So the blackout time when you're doing multiple frames is being reduced vastly. So
it's vastly reduced, yeah. So that together with the improved autofocus, and while we're talking about autofocus, we've also got a number of different custom modes for the autofocus now. So you can fine-tune autofocus to take account of subjects that need to be tracked across the frame or coming towards you. There are different scenarios in the setup, and even custom setups as well.
So specific setups for different scenarios. So say running, track event, or a football match where it's all slightly different movements.
The camera, or a vehicle coming towards you, a vehicle moving across the frame, animals.
So it's really, really headed at action, wildlife and sports photographers now.
Yes.
It's a very well-equipped, fast-moving camera which you can easily outperform a DSLR, I would say.
Together with the range of Fujinon lenses now that we have, I think we've got a lot of bases covered.
Excellent. The area where Fuji have been, it's fair to say, probably not as high up with the other guys is the video market, but I think Fuji have really addressed that with this camera.
Yes, it's now got 4K video, something that the sensor and processor was capable of in the X Pro 2. But due to size restrictions and the heat sink needed for 4K video recording, we've minimally made this camera larger to incorporate the heat sink for 4K. The 4K is pretty much competitive with what's available in the industry with log recording, uncompressed video, compressed video. You can also use film simulation modes, and continue. And you can change the aperture
during filming.
During filming,
yeah,
which is quite a key.
Quite a key feature. So, along with the improved video recording capability, have we got a headphone jack on the?
Yes, there's a headphone
and a
jack.
Mic.
Yes, in the camera ports here, you've got a headphone jack, mic, HDMI. HDMI out, that's micro HDMI. There's USB 3 port as well for fast downloading. A remote jack,
and we've got a port on the grip here.
And
as
on
well,
the grip
we?
Here, you've got a port with
headphone socket. Yeah.
And also you'll see there's an AC socket there. So one thing we should mention about this grip as well, you can actually charge batteries in the grip. So you could actually take the camera off the grip, use the grip as a dual charger, and still continue shooting with the camera.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Pete, for that. I'm sure it's going to be a huge success. We can't wait to get them in store.
Yeah, can't wait to sell you a few.